Coming up on Unpeeled,
Nicki Minaj announces her retirement.
Jake Gyllenhaal returns to Broadway and delivers an hour-long monologue.
And Crazy Rich Asian screenwriter Adele Lim quit the sequel over a pay dispute.
And we sit down with University Union to discuss the upcoming homecoming comedy show.
All that and more coming up on Unpeeled. Welcome to a brand new season of Unpeeled. I'm Landon Wexler.
And I'm Kerri McAneney.
Antonio Brown, the wide receiver on the New England Patriots, has been accused of sexually assaulting his former trainer. The accuser, Brittany Taylor, filed a lawsuit in the Southern District of Florida on Tuesday.
According to the lawsuit, Brown sexually assaulted Taylor on three separate occasions between 2017 and 2018. The Patriots said in a statement released hours after Taylor filed the lawsuit, "We take these allegations very seriously. Under no circumstances does this organization condone sexual violence or assault. The league has informed us that they will be investigating. We will have no further comment while that investigation takes place."
Now, Kerri, there's clearly a lot to break down here.
Definitely.
Very serious news. But something to keep in mind is that Brown is vehemently denying that this ever happened, which is often the case with a lot of these sexual misconduct allegations.
Yeah, definitely. His accuser, according to TMZ, passed the lie detector test. Not always reliable, though. Many studies prove that it's not reliable at all.
Right, absolutely. I learned that in psych class once. Mm-hmm. It's not the most reliable. However, it's always good to believe. We always have to believe the accuser at this point. You know, we don't want to make any allegations. We don't need to be saying too much. But I think we got to honor her allegation here.
Definitely.
According to her story, Brown had this all kind of went. It was a lot of different episodes of sexual assault. But he committed the crime or did whatever she accused him of. Mm-hmm. And then he apologized. And then after he apologized, she said, "Okay, I have accept your apology." After that, he unfortunately committed the act again.
Yes, definitely. A New York Times reporters published a book earlier this week detailing the reporting done by the Times to uncover former producer Harvey Weinstein's decades of sexual harassment. Jodi Kantor and Megan Toohey covered the initial story that started the Me Too movement and co-wrote the book, she said, breaking the sexual harassment story that helped ignite a movement.
Right, and the book features testimonials from Gwyneth Paltrow, Weinstein's brother, and a top executive at the Weinstein Company. The book also reveals that Weinstein ran a smear campaign against the reporters and delves into Christine Blasey Ford's testimony against Justice Kavanaugh. Now, of course, this is another unfortunate story we have going on, but there was one quote that particularly stuck out that Bob Weinstein said, right?
Yes, the book includes a letter his brother Bob Weinstein wrote Harvey 2 years prior to the story originally broke. "You have brought shame to the family and your company through your misbehavior. Your reaction was once more to blame the victims or to minimize the behavior in various ways. If you think nothing is wrong with your misbehavior, so in this area, then announce it to your wife and family."
Right. Absolutely. That's it's a pretty powerful statement.
Yes,
that
very powerful, especially if coming from his brother.
Right, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Now, at this point, a lot of the statement came from Gwyneth Paltrow, as I mentioned, and she was one of the first voices to stand out against Harvey Weinstein, and it's an unfortunate story, but hopefully justice will come to fruition here.
Mm-hmm. In much lighter news, Apple announced they will launch Apple TV Plus, the company's new streaming service, less than 2 weeks before Disney releases theirs, Disney Plus. At Apple's fall product event, CEO Tim Cook announced Apple TV Plus will open on November 1st for $5 per month. Disney announced about a month ago that Disney Plus will commence November 12th and cost $7 per month.
That's right, and each streaming company is competing with different offers and different incentives to subscribe. A subscription to Disney Plus also comes with a bundle with ESPN Plus and ad-supported Hulu. Now, Apple also announced at the event that they will be offering a free one-year subscription to Apple TV Plus with the purchase of an iPad, an Apple TV, or a Mac. What a deal, right?
Yes, Exactly, especially in time for the holidays. I think this is a great thing for people to be given the opportunity to try out,
right.
Especially Apple TV, Disney Plus. And also we found out from Netflix that their most viewers are coming around in later in the year. So it's just perfect timing, honestly.
Right. Absolutely. Now, $4.99 per month for Apple TV.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot of content to look forward to. Mm-hmm. We have the morning show is one of their originals. They have a lot of what Apple is advertising here is that they're advertising their original content. Now, one of the shows is the morning show.
Yes.
We have Steve Carell, we have Jennifer Aniston, and we have Reese Witherspoon.
Reese without her spoon as well.
Absolutely. Now, yes, without.
I'm sorry, I had to do it. But this looks like a stellar lineup with a stellar cast. And it just seems like there's a lot of star players. Oprah's even coming along for a book club sort of thing that she's doing.
That's pretty big. That's pretty big. Now, I think with all these, it's like a streaming war at this point. We have so many different options to take in. Hopefully Apple does well, but something tells me that Disney Plus is on my mind. But I'm not gonna make any rash decisions here.
Mm-hmm.
Coming up after the break, after 13 years in rap game, Nicki Minaj is hanging up her mic.
And Jake Gyllenhaal is picking one up. Stick around, Unpeelers.
It's a beautiful day out here. Sunny today with light breezes, giving way to clouds in the afternoon. We could see some light precipitation to moderate precipitation later on, followed by powerful storm-like conditions. 90 miles per hour winds are expected. Authorities are asking everyone, stay indoors.
Come on, that's it, let's go.
Superheroes?
Just four brothers who hate bullies and love this city.
Welcome back, Unpeelers. Nicki Minaj shook the entertainment world this week after announcing her retirement from music in a since-deleted Twitter post. In the tweet, Minaj expressed a desire to step away from music to spend more time with her family, leaving fans and supporters stunned at her surprise announcement. Here to give us the latest on Nicki's status is Unpeeled music reporter Patrick Gunn.
Welcome, Patrick. Now, there's clearly a lot to break down here, but clearly Nicki Minaj has been a part of our childhoods. Why is she leaving?
Well, Queen Latifah said recently about the news that she's been working hard over her career, and that's pretty true. She's been at this since 2008 when she was leading Lil Wayne's tour. She released her first single in 2009 and then her first album in 2010. So she's been incredibly busy so far in her career. It's understandable if she wants to slow down a little bit and wrap things up. And recently, Justin Bieber was... he's taking a break a couple months ago, and we were behind that too. So if people are in the spotlight this long, she's been involved with making over 100 songs and getting involved with feuds on and off. She's been incredibly stressful time. If she wants to take a little bit of time to step back, it's no problem there.
Really can't blame her at that point.
When you create a masterpiece like Starship, you should be entitled to some rest.
To fly, right?
Yes. Starships were meant to fly. So
hands up and touching the sky.
Yes, unfortunately.
I'm going to kill it right now. Continue, Kerri.
So what do we know about her trying to start a family?
Well, she is incredibly serious about trying to start a family with Kenneth Petty. So much so that on Twitter, she changed her Twitter bio to Miss Petty. There are hints that she may possibly be pregnant. In a new song that she released with Chance the Rapper, there were lyrics came up that basically said she hinted that she might be having a baby. So it looks so. These things are pretty. She's pretty serious getting into that relationship.
Right now, I'm glad she's found someone. That's great. But there is a little bit about this guy that is news, right? So we have the fact that he is a registered sex offender, and he has shot and killed a man.
Does that complicate things here, Pat?
Yeah, it okay. complicates All things right. a little bit. He obviously really isn't the best person, but right now, Nicki is tuning all of that out. In her music video for the song Megatron that came out a couple months ago, she had Petty featured heavily in the video. They were doing dancing all around, and so obviously I would say that Petty isn't the most reliable person, but for now, Minaj is supporting him. We'll see how long this lasts.
Right.
Yeah, so do you think that she'll be coming out with new music at all, or do you think she's really going to be taking this break to focus on her own life? Is it logistically possible for her to do it?
Logistically, I think it is possible for her to step away for a little while. I think Queen Latifah also said something that the poll will bring her back at some point. So who knows how long this break is going to last? Who knows how long this family attempt is going to be? I think that it wouldn't be surprised me if we see some more hits from Nicki Minaj coming soon.
Right. Something tells me Nicki is not going anywhere for too long. And while Nicki gets off the stage, Jake Gyllenhaal is getting back on the stage. The Academy Award nominee returns to Broadway to deliver an hour-long monologue. Simon Stevens and Nick Payne's play, Seawall, A Life, opens September 3rd and closes on September 29th. Gyllenhaal's monologue takes up 1 hour of the play's 1 hour and 45 minute runtime. That's a lot. Unpeeled's pop culture reporter, Katie Lane, is here to discuss Gyllenhaal's third role on the Broadway stage. Welcome, Katie.
Thank you guys for having me.
Yeah, I'm excited for you to be here. I'm excited to talk about Jake Gyllenhaal, but tell me what the show's about. I have no clue what's going on.
Okay, so the show is called Seawall, A Life. It is two acts. So Tom Sturridge, he's a famous actor from England. He is the man in the first act. So he talks about the loss of, without giving too much away, the loss of his daughter and how he kind of blames her death on his father-in-law. So. Little twist there. And then Jake Gyllenhaal has the second act to him, and his is a little more comedic. He talks about his wife and they're having a baby together, but then at the same time also losing his dad. So it is, while it is humorous at points, it is a very deep show, and right. they really want people to feel something when they are leaving the theater and sharing their stories with other members of the audience.
Mm-hmm. Right. Powerful stuff.
That's very true. Now, Gyllenhaal has clearly made many superfans feel things along the years, right? So, she's sweating over here. Not in like the best way possible. don't mean to call you out there, Kerri, but now a lot of people are saying that superfans are only going to see Gyllenhaal, the snack himself. What do you think? Did you notice that it was only Gyllenhaal superfans at this point?
So, thankfully, most of the people that were there were well-respected fans of his. Also fans of theater, but a lot of them were fans of his films, whether it be from October Sky way, way back, The Day After Tomorrow, but because of his new summer release this summer with the MCU, a lot more teenagers have become fans of him. So with that came a lot of people coming after the show to the stage door, and they were kind of like almost attacking him in a way. They were kind of bombarding the area, and he was getting a little noticeably upset because he wants them to be there for the show, for mm-hmm. theater, to experience theater, not him.
Not the Gyllenhaal show.
Yeah, it's not the Gyllenhaal show.
Even though it is for a lot of
people. Yeah, I would go for the Gyllenhaal show.
Right.
A lot of theater goers are giving this a lot of buzz. They're talking about a Tony Award for the actors in the show. Do you think they're actually in the running?
It's hard to tell because it is it's not a long run of a show. It's pretty short. It's only like a month. So I'm not sure, but I know a lot of shows are leaving Broadway, so that might open up some space for them to slide right in.
Now, something I've been very, very, very curious about this whole time. I heard Gyllenhaal sat on your lap.
Yes.
How did that happen? How did that work out?
We need to talk about this.
Okay, it was really funny because both actors were like very interactive with the audience. So they were like looking into people's eyes and everything, which was different, but very cool. And so at one point he came down and he came into the audience and he just got to my row and he was like, excuse me, to the people next to me. I was in the middle of the row. And he just climbed across all these people, just sat on my lap and did like part of the scene and was like, I love you. I love you. I'm never leaving you.
Did you want him to leave? Did you tell him to leave?
I was like, no, don't leave. Okay. don't leave me.
Good God. Well, thank you so much, Katie. That was great.
Yeah. Coming up, take your game day from the silver screen to the big screen.
Find out how AMC is bringing football to the movies. Next on Unpeeled.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Mm-hmm. Let's crawl. Mm-hmm. Come on, let's crawl. Hey, yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl.
When I was in foster care, I never knew when I would have to move. So I always had my suitcase ready to go. Then one day, I was adopted. My new parents opened their hearts and home to me. My parents cook my favorite breakfast for me every morning. My parents take me on trips I never thought I would go on. They gave me a home and an even better reason to use that suitcase. My parents aren't perfect, but they're perfect for me.
Welcome back, Unpeelers. AMC Theaters began broadcasting football games in over 50 markets this weekend. Your seats are included with a purchase of a $10 food and drink coupon. Here to give us the rundown and his thoughts on the AMC's new venture is the one, the only, Unpeeled's industry reporter, Liam Crowley. Welcome to the table, Liam.
Thank you for that introduction. That was so kind.
Of course, that's what I'm here for.
Thank you so much for coming. So what's the reason for this new push?
I mean, let's not beat around the bush here. This is entirely an attempt to get people to go back to the theater. AMC launched AMC A-List a while back, a subscription-based service to try to get people to come more often, and it didn't really work out. Now, theater attendance peaked 15 years ago, and it's been on a steady decline ever since. Despite earning around $12 billion last year, that's due to increased ticket prices. Now, the theater attendance is still there for the big event films. I'm talking your Avengers, Star Wars, Fast and Furious, all that good stuff, but those are only a few times a year. And as you guys mentioned earlier, Apple TV Plus is coming, Disney Plus is coming, streaming services are declaring war on the cinemas. And why not turn to the NFL? I mean, these guys own a day of the week. And if you can now get fans to come into your theater, the games are free, as you mentioned, with a whole prepaid food card.
Right.
But the good thing about that is it gets people to sign up for AMC Stubs. It's a free insider program, but it gets you on their listserv, gets you on their email. You come for one game, you're getting all these emails now, and it's going to make shareholders very happy.
Right. Now, I'm hoping we don't ruin AMC's business as a whole just by talking about this. Do you think that this is actually going to do well?
I mean, I think it's going to get some, especially from cable cutters. I mean, half the time people still keep cable around is just so they can watch live sports. And the fact that this is now being offered on a weekly basis, I mean, you pay $10 a week to see an NFL game, that's like $40 for the month. That's much cheaper than your cable package. Yeah, people prefer to watch games in a living room setting, but I mean, think about it. You're going to get people coming to the theater and eventually going to see your movies. What if they decide to stick around after a game? They're having a good time, they go see a movie. And box office numbers, they tout Friday through Sunday as the most profitable days for these cinemas, with Sunday being the least out of the three. That's the day to watch football. And theaters still have that event film revenue that I talked about, but those really only profit if they're in theaters for a long time. It's usually a 60-40 split, 60% going to the studio, 40% going to the cinema. But when you have the big films, your Endgame, Star Wars, distribution rights are north of 90%. I mean, if you ever wonder why your popcorn and soda cost you $25, it's the only way these theaters make any money.
Right.
So I think that all in all, this is a smart and low-risk maneuver for AMC theaters.
It makes every bit of sense. And Apple TV, or with Disney coming out with their bundle with ESPN Plus, I think this AMC has a little bit more to worry about.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Kerri, I know you had one other
Yes, I do, actually. Liam, I'm just really curious, will you be watching any of the games in your local cinema?
Well, you actually might catch me there, because here's a catch. Because there's an NFL policy when it comes to local broadcast affiliates, AMC theaters cannot show teams in their local markets. So this is genius for those college students, those people living away from their hometowns. I mean, I can't watch my beloved New England Patriots every Sunday on local Syracuse TV, so I might just have to go to my local AMC, rally my Bostonians, you know what I mean?
I think you can find a couple around here, right?
Hopefully.
Yeah. Don't want to deflate them, you know what I'm saying?
Let's not talk about it.
I had to do it. While AMC hopes to fill movie seats, some are leaving the movies altogether. Adele Lim, co-writer of the blockbuster hit Crazy Rich Asians, officially quit writing the two upcoming sequels after a pay dispute with Warner Brothers. Earlier this week, Lim explained that women and people of color are often marginalized in her situation and only used to provide culturally appropriate details. Unpeeled film reporter Andrew Goldberg joins us now with the latest on Lim's departure.
Welcome, Goldie. Oh, I'm sorry, Andrew.
It's okay.
Goldie's my nickname for him, but we're going to go
along
with it.
Thank you for having me on the show.
So tell me, Andrew, why? What were the factors that led to his departure?
So there are a few things coming into play here, but the main reason for the departure is Adele Lim is just not being paid fairly. Sources have revealed that she's only making about 1/10 of what her co-writer, Peter Chiarelli, is set to make for the upcoming sequel in the Crazy Rich Asians franchise. Reports say that while Lim is slated to make around $110,000, reports say that Chiarelli can make close to $1 million. And, I mean, I'm not a math major, but simple math tells me that that seems kind of incorrect. And while Chiarelli has offered to split some of his fee with Adele, she says, Peter has been nothing but incredibly gracious. However, what I make shouldn't be dependent on the white writer. So, pretty powerful statement.
For sure.
And very true. So, how did Warner Brothers respond to Lim's allegations?
So, the interesting thing here is that Warner Brothers' response wasn't really much of a response at all. In fact, they actually came out and defended their business negotiations team. Now, director John Chu did chip in and say he tried to work with her on coming to a solution that they could all agree on. But at the end of the day, enough time had passed where she wasn't really interested anymore. She declined his offer. And Chu said he was proud of the way she handled herself through these negotiations, but I don't see a resolution coming anytime soon because it seems like these two sides are pretty far apart.
For sure. And these kind of deals, these kind of decisions really take some time to kind of figure out.
Without question.
Now, taking that all in, do you think that was the right call?
So it's a pretty difficult decision. I mean, Crazy Rich Asians was number one at the box office when it first came out. It's a major hit, and I anticipate the sequel will be as well. But at the same time, at some point you have to take a stand when you think something's wrong, and this is a big decision for her. Clearly, the math is showing that she's being underpaid and undervalued by Warner Brothers, and I think she's setting a message not only for herself in the future, but for other women and people of color that if you want good, talented writers to work with you, you're going to have to pay the appropriate amount, not just what you think is good for a culturally appropriate writer, a real legitimate writer who can contribute a lot to your story.
Right. I think if Warner Brothers doesn't notice it, I think one other studio will, you know?
Yes.
Do you think that at this point, do you think that Crazy Rich Asians 2 is going to be anywhere near as good as the first one?
Well, it remains to be seen. Chiarelli is a solid writer, but at the same time, I think they will be missing a lot of what Adele Lim brought to the table in terms of her knowledge and background in this situation. And, I mean, she has rights for discrimination. She could really go after Warner Brothers, so I think they will see the repercussions one way or another.
For sure. Absolutely. Thank you so much, Andrew. Appreciate
all
the insight. Coming up, Michael Che is coming to the campus this weekend.
Unpeeled Syracuse Events reporters sits down with the University Union to talk about the homecoming comedy show next on Unpeeled.
Looking for these? You drive buzzed, it could be one very expensive ride.
First, you gotta make bail. Then pay me to get your car back.
Your insurance premiums will go through the roof.
And my legal fees just keep adding up. All told, it could end up costing you $10,000.
Buzzed, busted, and broke. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
Hey, Hard, what's this?
That's my resignation letter.
You're resigning.
Why? Because you're constantly ignoring me. You're half as active as you used to be, and you eat stuff like this.
You've been putting me under a lot of pressure lately.
That's why I'm ready to quit.
I forgot. I'll do better. Please, don't quit on me.
Okay, but remember, it's not what you say. It's what you do.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you.
Let's go for a walk.
Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to a stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the ways I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Welcome back, Unpeelers. In honor of homecoming week at SU, University Union is hosting a comedy show featuring Michael Che. The show takes place September 13th at 8 p.m. in Goldstein Auditorium. In addition to Michael Che, Rosebud Baker and Cephas Sounds will perform at the event as well. Our Syracuse events reporter Joyce Kim is sitting down with University Union to discuss the homecoming comedy show this weekend. Take it away, Joyce.
Thanks, Kerri. I'm here with University Union's Performing Arts Director Michael Larkin and Public Relations Director Mackenzie Glaubitz. So, how are you guys? Thanks for coming.
We're good. Thank you for having us. We're super excited to do this.
So, I just had like a couple questions for you guys. Mm-hmm. How did you decide on this amazing lineup for this comedy show?
Yeah. So, when we were looking for artists, we really wanted someone that could bring the current undergraduate community together with alumni, because this is homecoming weekend. Michael Che is widely known for the Weekend Update on SNL, so we just figured he's someone that, you know, older alumni could like, young students could like, bring everyone together into the space for a good time. And he usually travels with Cypher Sounds and Rosebud Baker. They're both great. They're hilarious. A little offbeat, raunchy comedy is always fun on a college campus.
Exactly. The parents would love that, right?
Yeah, for sure. So they're really going to kick it. I think it's going to be an awesome show.
Okay. Yeah. And what are these comedians best known for, would you say? What are their best highlights?
In doing their research, Michael Che is obviously best known for Saturday Night Live. Mm-hmm. That's sort of where he found his most notable fame. He also does a lot of stand-up on the side and is super hilarious. Rosebud Baker is all around in live comedy. She's won a lot of different comedy competitions. She's been on Comedy Central. She's been on Amazon Prime, some comedy specials there. She also has her own podcast called Two Less Lonely Girls. Which picks up a lot of traction. It'll be good to see an artist from that type of media here on campus. And Cypher Sounds almost 16 or 17 years was on Hot 97, which is a radio station
in
New
York. These
are
all reputable comedians,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So will you guys be going to the show?
Yeah, we're actually going to be working
it.
What
are you looking most forward to in the show?
Well, I'm a huge Michael Che fan myself, huge SNL Weekend Update fan, so I mean, like, obviously, super excited to see what he does for stand-up, because I've never seen it before, so it'll be good.
Okay, and are you expecting some kind of turnout? Have you heard any from friends or people that are planning on going? What are they expecting? Are they excited? Do they like it?
Yeah, we've gotten actually great responses, I think. We just had Juice Jam last weekend, so we're kind of still rolling off the excitement from that. People want more. People want something to do. Plus, like, alumni weekend, you always want to see your old friends. So a comedy show is a perfect way to, like, get together and laugh it
off.
So people are excited.
Mm-hmm. And just, like, adds to lighthearted mood, just, like, being together, just having a good time.
Right. Definitely.
So this event is in collaboration with the Traditions Commission.
Yes.
So does that mean this event is something that we can expect to happen every year, maybe, possibly?
Yeah, actually, so we partner with them every year for the homecoming show. We brought Anthony last year with them, so this year we're doing it with them. So this is a yearly thing, and we love doing it. They're super sweet, and we get to crown the homecoming king and queen at the show, so it's a whole, like, cute little collaboration thing. So yes, it is a yearly thing.
So much fun.
Yeah.
Okay, so maybe I'll go to that this year and next year.
Yeah.
And general details, when do doors open? Important question.
Yes. Doors open at 7:15. The show starts at 8. Tickets are on sale for $5 to students, $10 to faculty, staff, and alumni, and $15 to general public.
Okay, that's great to know. I probably might end up being there.
Yes.
And thank you so much for coming in with us today.
Thank you.
Throwing it back to Kerri.
Thanks, Joyce. Thanks so much for joining us on this first episode, the new season of Unpeeled. I'm Kerri McAneney. Have a great night, Unpeelers.